Yo, what's going on, YouTube? What's going on, man? It's cold, man. It's another cold, rainy, wet, soaky day out here. Appreciate you guys for joining my channel. This is Out Here Trucking. As you guys can see, y'all can't see. But I'm in this lumber yard right now. And I'm just trying to get myself unloaded. There go my truck. I just got a couple of more bundles. Just got a couple more bundles to come off. It's something light today for real. I only had one stop today because I didn't get back to the yard until like, I think I got back to the yard. I left at like 9 o'clock, man. I was driving. I was coming across, coming out of Virginia, coming into Maryland. I was crossing over the Woodrow Wilson Bridge. I was in the far right lane. And I mean, I definitely did was looking ahead, but this, whatever this material was, it was so flat and it had like a little something. It was like something attached to it or whatever, but I tried to go to my left to avoid it, but I couldn't go too far because it was a vehicle that was right there. And so, man, I messed around and I rolled over it by accident, of course. And next thing I know, I'm driving up the road. There was another driver. He flagged me down. Look, I pull over. I check. Man, that joint punctured my damn fuel tank on my passenger side, man. So I had to call a breakdown. And they came out, sent the tow truck. We basically swapped trucks because my company, we just renting these trucks right now. Well, we swap trucks. You know, they got the hazmat environment group to come out there to get, you know, clean up the mess or whatever. But, I mean, the whole process took, that happened like around 2:30. And I didn't get back to the yard until like 9 o'clock. And I was only 50 miles away from the yard. But as I was trying to tell you guys, man, the newbies, the rookies out there, like, you know, it don't matter if you just started driving. Don't matter if you've been driving for 30 years. Like, sometimes it's just some things that happen out here on the road that goes beyond your control. But you just keep trucking, man. You know, you make the best of your situations. Make sure you keep your supervisors, your managers, your dispatchers, everybody in the loop, you know. That's another thing too. If something happens, if you're a newbie and you know, fresh out truck driver school, whatever, man, the faster you can contact your management and let them know your situation, let them know what's going on, the faster they can get somebody out to you and get that situation taken care of, man. Don't be afraid to be like, you know, don't be scared, think you're gonna get fired or whatever. Like, in the trucking industry, man, it's just a part of it, you know. And each company, they, you know, they know that. So that's why they have, you know, the proper protocols already set aside for you guys to follow. And don't worry about, you know, they got all that. They got an expense account. They got all that stuff taken care of, man. So, man, you just go out there, do what you got to do. And, man, you'll be just fine, man. So, you know, that's what happened to me yesterday. They actually almost finished loading me up. Then I'm probably going to take this truck over to the shop so I can get some air in one of my drive tires. Make sure that joint is filled up. Yeah, man, always, yeah, that's another thing, too. Always, you should be doing this anyway. Because, of course, you know, you guys, you do your pre-trip in the morning, you do your post-trip when you finish for the day. But even like right now, you know, I'm stopped. And I'm just waiting for them to take off those last couple of bundles right there on my truck. I'll randomly go around, you know, check out my tires or whatever. Or just, you know, inspect my trailer, inspect my tractor, just to see if I notice anything or whatever. But that's what happened today. I was just doing a run around. And just happened to notice that one of my drive tires was kind of low, so I'm gonna go ahead and get that taken care of once I finish getting unloaded here, and then head back to my yard, call it a day, and go home, probably get me a cold one or something to eat, and just, you know, go from there, man. So, yeah, as soon as it do, hurry up, I'll be able to get out this rain, man, because it's a little chilly. I think we're getting all this weather from the hurricane down there in Florida, man, and I hope everybody is doing all right. I'm not sure if you guys got family or friends or loved ones down there. I know from the pictures that I saw and the video footage that I saw down there, yo, man, no disrespect to anybody who lives in the area, but yo, y'all can have that Florida stuff, man. I can't do that for real. Like, that's just too much, man. It was crazy. I seen cars, I seen people's boats floating down the damn road, and like, nah, man. So hopefully everybody makes it out of that situation all right. You know, but yeah, man. Anyway, like I said, I just wanted to let y'all know what happened yesterday, and you know, hopefully everybody's out here being safe. I'll go ahead and call it a dub for now. I'll catch you guys on the next one, all right? Peace.